Come when you're ready and we'll start. Yeah? We're in the middle of a question and an answer, actually, so we'll start from the beginning of that particular question. And this is into the second section of Pishkub Yud, about 10 lines down. The line begins with the word Ohamachshava. In discussing Moichin and Midas, where we said Moichin is the Atzmon, and Midas is the Azulos, we brought in Machshava and Dibur as a means of understanding these principles of the Atzme and Azulos. Where there's a clarity, because Machshava is Le'atzma, clearly, and Bibur is Le'chazulus. The difference between Machshava and Dibur is not only that the Zulus cannot know what you're thinking. The real difference is that thinking and speech are at two different levels. They reach in to the principle that is being discussed in a different way. Machshava is privy to the essence, to the source, and to the imperative aspect, whereas Dibur comes afterwards, that which can be expressed, which can be revealed. So we're starting at this line, Machshava hu agivu liyatzmei. Machshava is a givu to himself. Or mikol mokoi, however, even so, gam bechinas idias atzmei, also and even, the bechina, the aspect of idias atzmei, of knowing himself, which clearly means knowing himself to himself. However, he bishvil ha'ishtalshul, it is bishvil ha'ishtalshulus, it is for the sake of the ishtalshulus, of that which develops further down, step by step into worlds. What makes us say that? The Hina. There's a basis for saying this.
Which line?
The line begins, Amachshov ha'agil yatzmei. It is five lines above the little pe gimel on the side.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
This aspect of Yidias Atzmei, of knowing himself, is also Bishvil HaYishtalshulus. It is for the sake to enable Hishtalshulus. There has to be a basis of saying this. Hine, for behold, L'choyro in a move on. There's an apparent question over here. Me'achar shezehu rak lagal in helen ha'atzmi. Being that machshav, or we're talking about moichin, is the inyan, is only legales, to reveal helem ho'atzmi, that which is deeply concealed in essence, the essential helem, the basis of the etzem, legabe atzmi, to reveal this basis of the etzem to himself. This is what moichin is. If that's the case, what was the purpose of the emanation, of bringing it forth into a presence? This moichin that his the helem ha'atzmi, that which is the essential truth of Atzmus, belong to himself. What is the purpose of that? The Harei, since that the Atzmus is Borech, for his Atzmus is Borech, for his Atzmus itself, Yodua, it is well known, Gam Koidim Shenetz. In Atzmus is all known, it's all known to himself, Gam Koidim Shenetz, even before Moichin, and the means of identifying this knowledge has emanated. Internally, everything is known. Therefore, to what purpose did it emanate for? He says the emanation is that he should know it. It stays in his own knowledge. He has not ventured outside. It stays within his knowledge, but to stay within his own knowledge, it doesn't have to come to the Chochmah level. It is known even in its obscured state, undefined state. It is also known. This is an important principle. And from all the Mishorim that we are talking about, we have to understand. The Moshe for this is, of course, the Nefesh Odom. Seven thirty. Excuse me? Yeah. We have a tough gabbai over here.
What?
We have a tough gabbai over here. Okay. To him himself, it is known even before Chochmah is emanated.
To remain on this call, press 1.
Nuisance.
Returning to the conference room.
This union that Latzmusa is Borech, it is known even before the Chochmah or the faculty of knowledge has emanated. This is what's called it's a imperative principle. The motto for this is a child, for example, tries to stand up. before it even succeeded to try to stand up or to crawl, or even better, as an infant, it babbles, it always talks. It's a very beautiful thing to watch. What is this talking, this infinite talking? Even though it is not capable to express himself in a manner that he would tell his mommy what he wants to say. But he's saying, he's experiencing his own life internal to himself, and he's experiencing it's real life. And the point of saying this is that a living soul, that ultimately, when it develops in a person, to the point where the person becomes a very productive and active entity, and he brings out all the depths and all the insights of his soul, the developing aspect is only developing that which is already in the soul. The soul is not being trained to say what it says. He knows that he's able to speak before he speaks. The reason for that is, I mean, the reason to understand this principle, the principle in this is that the reason a person speaks is not elicited, that's not brought out by the fact that he has somebody to talk to. But it is actually the expression of what his soul is about, what his life is. The essence of his love is that he has a profound insight of what life is, and he also is a presence in the bigger world. And he understands, he knows that principle, that is a presence in the bigger world before he experiences it. As we said many times, that the reason, the real presence is of a human being is the mission with which he was conceptualized to begin with. The human being came to the world with a mission at inception, not after the fact. To participate in the world. That is his mission. As the Pasuk expresses it. And therefore, this mission exists in the very essence of what the soul is. And this is the meaning that it's known to him even before it emanates, even the means, the koiches, the function and the functional faculties emanate. The functioning faculty emanate as a result of this, of the essential knowledge. As he pointed out many times, that when a person ultimately learns how to speak, he does not emulate speech. He speaks from inside. So therefore it is known, Gam Kereshenetz. So therefore, for what purpose were the faculties, or the koiches, or the qualities that ultimately bring out this knowledge of himself to himself, what is the purpose of that? Ahu inyan hu. However, the principle in this is Bigday, Sheyeye Mitzius, Bechinas Chochma. That in order that there should be a presence of Bechinas Chochma, of the Chochma aspect, Shegam Zulos, Yuchal Havino, that ultimately, that even someone else should be able to understand the Chochma, that ultimately that is what Chochma is, that after Chochmi emanates, it is able to be explained to Zulas. The initial state is where it is known only to himself. But ultimately, the Chochmi is enabling for him to express it to someone else. In order that there should be a Chochmi ultimately, such that the Zulas should be able to understand, for that it was necessary, this is very subtle, it was necessary that it should emanate Tchila first Metzius Shem Chochma. The Metzius, the presence of Shem Chochma, the term Chochma. Something had to be, Shem means a name, identifying something, identifying a concept with the name Chochma. And what is the purpose of a concept of the name Chochma? It doesn't exist yet. But identifying that such a concept exists. Shem Chochma. She'adayin in Eshaya klal gil hazulis. At that point, it is not as yet pertinent the Gilui Hazulas to be revealed to the Zulas. Because this is not even a present, this is just a concept, an internal concept of Chochmah. It's not pertinent for others, there's nothing there to know. And yet, that conceptualized idea of an identity of Chochmah Rakshay Bidias Atzmi Ideas Atim, where at that point it is only Dias Atzmi by knowing himself, he knows the Torah. Because in Chochmah, Chochmah means he knows what there is to be known. And at that point he knows that there is such a thing as knowing. Shem Chochmah, the term Chochmah. But as a result, that Shenimtso Shem Chochmah, that the term Chochmah, something which is identifiable with the concept of Chochmah. Chochmah means to know. But the fact that such a concept has been identified, that knowledge exists, or the union of knowledge per se.
To remain on this call, press 1.
That knowledge per se is identified. As a result of Nitzot Chochmah, Nizhavo came to be Achar Kach, afterwards, Bechinas HaChochmah D'Atzilus. The aspect of Chochmah in the world of Atzilus. Then that aspect of Chochmah has emanated. At that state, it is Chochmah d'Atzilus. Atzilus, and we spoke many times, Atzilus is also one of the four words, Atzilus, Bli, Yetzirah, Asiyah. It's It's a world unto itself. But this world is an internal world. That's what it's called, Atzilut. Atzilut means an emanation, not a Bria, not a creation. External world is one starts from creation, Bria. This is not creation, this is just an emanation. Emanation means internal revelation of what there is internally, what the potential, what the possibilities are. That's emanation, that's Atzilut. And this becomes Chochmah d'Atzilus. This Chochmah d'Atzilus is real Chochmah, even though it's in level of Atzilus. But internally, this is really identified as a faculty of Chochmah. Let us now kind of focus in on this. Prior to Chochmah emanation, also there was knowledge, but there's two different types of knowledge. There's a knowledge that is known as a result of its source, of the totality of the truth. And then there's knowledge that's known as a result of knowing the particular thing itself. Like we say in our simple moshul, said the home, in concept, has all the furnishings that go with the home. The minute there's a home, that minute there is already the thought of what am I going to do with this home? How am I going to furnish it? The furnishings exist there. But there they exist only because of the concept of the home, not because each furnishing had been identified individually. Before he goes actually to furnish the house, he has to identify each piece of furnishing independently by itself. What does the table look outside of the home in order to have a table in the home? In other words, it has to be identified independently of the reality of the home. This is the inyan Shem Chochmah. In other words, the term, what are you, the term of this furnishing has to be identified as such, not as part as the home has everything. The home does have everything, but that will not enable you to actually ultimately go furnish it. How is it possible to furnish when you identify individually this particular thing? Same thing is in the Snimshul, that in Atzmusi everything is known. But the term knowledge had to be identified as such in order for it to emanate further down into actual knowledge. In himself he knows, but he doesn't know that he knows. Not only he doesn't know what he knows, he doesn't even know what knowledge is. So this is the emanation, Shem Shem Chochmah. This Shem Chochmah determines that knowledge exists. This is what enables, ultimately, Chochmah d'Atzilus, the actual Chochmah to emanate within the Atzim itself, but it's actual knowledge, determined knowledge. Shehu inyan bechinas Chochmah d'Teira. This is the inyan from Chochmah d'Teira. Kmei shehu levaila adayin. This is the Chochmah of Teira. The inyan of Teira is because Teira, this is what there is to know in Atzmus. There's nothing else. Teira is, what is the truth of Atzim? What is the truth of the course? And this Chochmah that Torah comes to be as a result of this Shem Chochmah, which is Lamaila Adayin, the way as it is Lamaila, as it is above, as it is in its source yet. He has not ventured out of the source. V'she'eina b'shvil hazulus. And at that point, it is not Bishvil Hazulus for the sake of the of an outside. Rak accept what has been accomplished there. Sheyichelo liyed b'asogas hazulus, that it is possible for this to be brought down in the comprehension of the Zulus. At that point, it is known only because of the truth of the Etzem. But it has been identified as such, and that which is identified, which has been identified, is such that that could be brought down to an outsider also, to the outside. The canal, the Perik Membov, and as we explained way back when, we explained Shebchinas HaChochma, that the aspect of Chochma Eino Bishvil Azulus is not for the sake of the outside. And we explained it very simply. Shehare Yochel Leishev Liatzmil Hasig Haskolos. Since that a person is capable to sit to himself, well, Haskil Haskolos, and to conceptualize concepts, he can actually actively pursue Chochmah. And it is internal to himself. He is not at this point communicating with anybody. Omno. However, he Chochmo Bimtzius Murgashus. It is Chochmo, it is knowledge, Bimtzius Murgashus, in a presence that it can be sensed. He does not know it just because he has everything because he is true. He knows knowledge per se. It is a Chochma Bimtzius Murgashus in a sensed presence. Shegam Zulosu Yuchal Havina. Such that should it be presented to someone else, he will be able to understand it. Because this is a real piece of knowledge. What is the difference between the loss that someone else will be able to understand and himself understand? This thing that someone else will be able to understand is a big accomplishment. Because he is able to understand because he has the essence. It's not, he doesn't understand because he understands it, but because he is it. But that it could be transmitted to someone else who is not that it, and yet he will be able to understand it. This is where the Chochmah had to be formed, Amitzius. And this Chochmah is a Metzius Murgashus, is an identifiable presence, such that is a losoi that someone else also Yuchal Havino should be able to understand it. Rak except Sheine Muchlach Sheachpil is a losoi. It is not imperative. He is not forced to bring it out to someone else. He has this knowledge. And he has something that can be pursued and give it out to someone else, but it's not imperative. To knowing for himself is also sufficient. Mm. It's also knowledge. K'moy ha-midas ha-moshul. In contrast to midas. Midas, for example, Shebehed el ha-hashpo, that if there is no hashpo, the midah does not really go in and affect the external, then mizbatel ha-midah, then the midah loses its presence. The holy name of the midah is to affect the outside. And if the midah does not come forth to be effective, then the midah ceases to exist, so to speak. As a midah, it ceases to exist. Whereas Chochmah is different, because Yuchali is Mitziusa, where the Mitzius of Chochmah is possible to be, Gambli Hashpoel Azulus, even without bringing it forth to someone else. The meaning of knowledge internal knowledge is a possible, is a real knowledge, even though this is such a knowledge that can be presented to someone else, but without presenting it to someone else, it stays where it is, it doesn't get lost. I will let him into you, so he be'efem, but the very essence of its presence is in such a man, in manner she yichoylo lehovi ha'osoga ha'zulis, that it could be possible to be bringing out ha'osoga ha'zulis to a comprehension of someone else. This is the union of chokhmah, when chokhmah emanates as an identifiable faculty, quality. He has not yet ventured out, but the concept of knowledge had been identified. At that point, he has the sense, the means by which he can communicate with someone else. Although it remains internal to himself. So, how are we taking to this? We finished this principle. Now we're going to the next step. How are we staying with this? Online, is it understood? Hello?
Yes. I'm getting a word. I had a question. What's the difference between emanation and creation?
Between what?
Emanation and creation. Essentially, the difference is creation is when it is created to stand on its own. Emanation is when it emanates and it is still dependent on its source. To express it simply, to give you a tangible principle, when you make a table stand on four legs, that's creation. Table begins to stand on its own. But this table has been conceptualized in your mind before you built it this way. When it was still in your mind, the idea has emanated. I can make a table stand on its own. That was an idea that formulated in your mind, in your seichel. It was not formulating because you looked at the space in the room and you see, oh, I can put a table over here. It was an idea within thought itself, within the mind itself, within the intellect itself. That's called emanation.
Idea that, what is in the idea that's emanation?
What?
What is in the mind, there is called emanation.
I don't understand.
In the mind, why is it there called emanation?
Why is it there?
In that location, why is it called emanation? If it's still in the mind.
Oh,
no.
Because prior to that...
No,
different question.
Yeah, I couldn't understand the question. Go ahead.
It's not a question, I'm just asking if while it's in the mind, there it's called emanation.
That's right. While it is still in the mind, and in the mind is not something, knowledge, from an external purpose. It is a knowledge that is drawn, that comes from inside, the nefesh. Like we said many times, talking again about the table. The table is a human concept. that a human beings, you know, served on the table. And this union that it's part, and so to speak, of the human self-dignity, that he doesn't sit on the floor or he sits in front of a table, that exists because of who he is. So when a human being begins to think, okay, how am I going to serve this breakfast? The idea of a table emanates from his sense of how things should be for him. This is called emanation. Prior to emanation, it is the real thing that he is a human being. Has not yet been identified in terms of how is that mean, what does that mean practically speaking. Emanation is when it actually surfaces in his mind that this is how this dignity would be expressed.